Over the past few months in the Washington, D.C., Maryland, and Virginia areas, the Black and brown, queer, transgender, and non-binary communities have experienced multiple different losses to substance use. Individuals directly and indirectly impacted by this issue all came together as a part of the National Trans Visibility March's Community Advisory Board to create a campaign to raise awareness about this issue. Those individuals created a campaign titled Our People, Our Purpose. The message behind this campaign is meant to promote the necessary community that individuals need, family, chosen family, biological family, that individuals need in order to make sure that they stay safe.
It would mean unity, and it would mean change. It would mean change because the one thing that's a problem in our community is division. And coming together, we would make such a powerful impact on the world as a whole, just being one.
Welcome to the 2021 National Trans Visibility Torch Awards. I want to thank Janssen Infectious Disease and Vaccines of Johnson & Johnson and Nation Z Foundation for their sponsorship. And the purpose of tonight is to award the individuals that are out in the community doing the work, doing the amazing things that it's going to take for us to move forward. This is a time to celebrate each other and the incredible work that is being done by the trans and non-binary individuals across the country. It's also a time to recognize allies who support the work of the community. Okay, we're gonna have a performance by the beautiful Tasha Long. Okay, so let's halt that. She's not quite ready. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to our first category. And I want to introduce to you Mimi Shelton, the director of Trans Incentives, Destination Tomorrow.
Hi, how's it going? I'm Mimi Shelton, everybody. It's nice to meet you. Thank you, Regina, so much for that introduction. I'm so happy to be here. I'm coming to you all live, loud, and in color, as my girl T.S. Madison says, from New York City, Brooklyn, New York, to be specific, from my bedroom. And it is 7 o'clock here. It's so nice to see you all, or to, you know, I feel you virtually. First and foremost, I just want to give a big shout out to One Orlando Alliance for organizing this march to Destination Tomorrow, my organization, Trans New York, and all the other organizations in the satellite cities this year. And now I would love to just really introduce the first set of awards as well as our speakers for today. So first and foremost, right now we have the I'll be presenting the Monica Roberts Award. Let me tell you a little bit more about the award. So Monica, AKA the Trans Griot, was a Houstonian, a native Houstonian, GLAAD award-winning blogger, writer, and award-winning trans human rights advocate. She was the founding educator of TransGriot, and her writing appeared at the Belrico Project, Ebony.com, the Huffington Post, and The Advocate. She worked to foster understanding and acceptance of trans people inside and outside communities of color. Among her many honors were the Virginia Prince Transgender Pioneer Award, the Robert Coles Call of Service Award, the Barbara Jordan Breaking Barriers Award, and the 2020 Susan J. Hyde Award for Longevity in the Movement. Monica Roberts was a 2020 National Trans Visibility March Torch Award winner herself. And we honor the legacy of Monica Roberts. May she rest in power always with this award. I'm going to introduce the first recipient of this award tonight and then let them speak. Our first recipient will be Kamarian D. Anderson Harvey. Kamarian D. Anderson Harvey is a vibrant and visible trans woman of color with a passion for inclusive and inclusion, and equality for all. Kamarian is the Alabama State Director with the Human Rights Campaign, HRC, under the Project One America initiative. Kamarian becomes the first trans person of color to serve in a leadership role with HRC in the organization's history. Before joining HRC, Kamarian worked in the field of public health and education in Texas, managing both local and national prevention initiatives, focusing on HIV/AIDS and other health disparities that impact marginalized communities. Kamarian is the founder and previous executive director for Black Trans Women, Inc., which is the first national nonprofit organization with a 501c3 with a programmatic focus to uplift the voices, hearts, and souls of Black trans women and in alliance with the Black Trans Advocacy Coalition. Kamarian also serves as the National Co-Minister and South Regional Coordinator for Trans Saints Ministry of the Fellowship of Affirming Ministers, TFAM, and previously served as an associate elder / minister at the Living Faith Covenant Church in Dallas, Texas for 15 years before relocating to Alabama. Kamarian is a wife, has one son, four bonus sons, and three adorable grandchildren. Everyone, I would love you to give a big round of applause, a virtual smile, clap, and a sound of celebration for Kamarian D. Anderson Harvey.
For those that know me, praise the Lord, everybody. You know how I do it. Praise the Lord, everybody. Well, listen here. So I'm going to do one little small correction because it's okay. But I'm a Southern girl. Y'all don't see these ham hocks, do you? But I'm a Southern girl. And my name is Kamarian. Can someone say Kamarian? And if you say it real fast, it's Kamarian. Amen. Amen. I'm so excited. I'm not going to be before you long. Let me just say this real quick. Let me lift up the award because it's here for those who got cameras and pictures. Thank you. This is quite an honor. I actually am from Dallas, Texas. I did a lot of work across the state of Texas, and actually Monica Roberts and I knew each other very personally. Monica's first cousin was my best friend, and when I launched Black Trans Women, Inc., in conjunction with Carter Brown with Black Trans Men, Inc., that then developed into Black Trans Advocacy Coalition, Monica Roberts was my first board member. And the work that she's done through TransGriot is immensely appreciated. As a woman of trans experience who happened to be Pentecostal, who happened to be a preacher, and all of that, I got my first exposure over 20 years ago in a blog of Monica Roberts, and I was ever so grateful because that was her biggest thing was to amplify the gifts and talent within our community. I was there when Monica Roberts was laid to rest. I was on the podium, and, you know, all I could have said was, well done, thy good and faithful servant. She has left us a blueprint. And so this blueprint and this award I'm receiving is for all of us. Monica wanted to make sure that our visibility was counted. You understand, right? If you knew Monica, that's why she wrote about our visibility. So every day we should follow that legacy that she left behind for us to be able to share our visibility in the most appropriate way. Can I say that real quick, saints? Can I say that? Okay, in the most appropriate way, because we are no longer victims as individuals of trans experience. Okay, you understand. We got to start showing up in a way where we demand what we want through our visibility. Tokenizing brings tokens. Come on, somebody. It bought me a house just a couple months ago, okay? So you understand. So, but we have that power in order to do that. So I'll leave you with this as something that Monica Roberts often shared and that I noticed about her. First of all, Monica could slide in anything. If Monica was traveling, Monica traveled with two nickels and never had to spend the two nickels because she was able to slide in because her gift made room for her. And that's what I want to leave you with. We all as trans-identified individuals have a gift. Let it make room for you. Amen. Let it make room for you. Let the people open you up. Don't expose yourself. Let them, you show up as the gift and have them open you up and be a blessing to the atmosphere where you're at. This award I do accept humbly, but I'm accepting on everyone because our visibility does count. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kamarian. And I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Next award, the next Monica Roberts Award goes to someone near and dear to my own heart, Mr. Sean Ebony Coleman, who is the founder and executive director of Destination Tomorrow. Mr. Coleman is a TLGBTQ center, or Destination Tomorrow, I should say, is a TLGBTQ center in the South Bronx, serving the community through educational, financial, housing, health, and personal support programs. As a nationally recognized leader in the transgender community and the first African-American of transgender experience to operate a TLGBTQ center in New York City, Sean plays a key role in advocating for policies that directly impact the lives of millions of TLGBTQ New Yorkers. Sean is also the founder and managing partner of Sean Ebony Coleman Consulting, where he specializes in DEI strategies for TLGBTQ communities. Now, please, everyone, give a warm welcome, a big hand, a virtual celebration, an applause to my founder and co-director, my friend, my boss, a great man in my life, Mr. Sean Ebony Coleman.
Wow. Thank you so much, Mimi, for that warm introduction. And thank you to all involved in selecting the honorees for the Monica Roberts Award. It's near and dear to me because Monica exemplified what it meant to be community, to have and show unconditional love to and for the community that's so often overlooked. When I started Destination Tomorrow, that was the entire purpose for me, to make sure that trans and gender non-conforming, non-binary people had a space to call their own, but also had access to resources, right? It's so incredibly important to be visible. Yes, it is. But it's also equally important to be counted, to direct your own narrative. And for far too long, we as trans and gender nonconforming folks have allowed others to tell our stories. I feel like Monica gave us an opportunity and a platform to take back those narratives, to begin to tell our own stories and tell them in ways that were beneficial to us. But it also exposed us to a different funding source, right? And we know money drives everything. So it gave us an opportunity to show statistics about what was happening in our community, to show accurate data that had already been so graciously collected by Monica. I'm just in awe of the work that she did for community. I know that she is greatly missed, but her legacy lives on, especially by way of the folks that have been awarded the Monica Roberts Award tonight. So to all of the co-honorees, I say congratulations. There's so much work for us to continue to do. I'm asking for reciprocal relationships. I don't want collaborations. I want reciprocal relationships. That means we all get something out of it. No longer will we accept subpar relationships and being tokenized and used. We want to make sure that there's equal pay, there's equal representation, and there's equity across the board when it comes to the trans and gender nonconforming community. Thank you all so much. I love you all. I wish I could be in Florida with you. Have a wonderful night.
Thank you so much, Sean. Thank you, thank you, thank you for that. And I am so appreciative of you and all the work that you do. Our next Monica Roberts Award goes to another person near and dear to my heart, another woman who has really inspired me, has inspired many youth and adults within the Destination Tomorrow community, as well as the House Ballroom community. And that woman is Nia Reed, AKA Sanaya Alea, who has been a part of the House and Ballroom community for over 3 decades, where she's an inspiration to many LGBTQ folks globally. Sanaya, as the intake specialist, or I should say Nia, excuse me, as the intake specialist at Destination Tomorrow, the Bronx LGBTQ Plus Center, for the last 4 years. And she continues to service the community as a familiar face, providing linkage to a number of gender-affirming services, surgery referrals, housing, name change, gender markers, et cetera, at Destination Tomorrow. She continues to be a role model and inspiration to her community in whatever vehicle she's placed. I want to give a huge round of applause, and I would like you all to join me in doing that for Nia Reed. Please give a warm welcome, a big celebration, a virtual clap, a clap in person for Nia Reed. Nia, unmute yourself.
Hi, Mimi. Thank you for that warm welcome. I'm so grateful. Well, first I want to say rest in power, Monica Roberts. You are so amazing, and the work that you've done will continue to live on through all of us. Secondly, I want to share a story of my life, of my transition growing up. My beginning was a bit selfish. I was a bit selfish and self-centered, trying to create this woman that I wanted to be. Then being introduced to the ballroom community, giving me a lane to drive this vehicle down that fueled this conflict, this competitive spirit where I was able to use and harness that, I guess, self-centeredness. I would say doing that for a few years. After a few years, I start to feel empty. I start to feel shallow, like it wasn't feeding my spirit anymore. So I knew that I was growing up first. And secondly, I knew that I had to shift my gears, and it was something I had to do that would impact my community other than entertain them. So I always said to myself that once I get my life in order, I'm going to do some sort of advocacy work to make a difference in my community. Little did I know, by just living in my authentic truth, I was doing the work. So many people were inspired by me. I gave so many young LGBTQ plus individuals hope to dream and live in their truth and be who they are. Sometimes I have to pinch myself when I receive these messages. It's like, wow, I've done all that. I did that. Oh my God. It was, I mean, now being at Destination Tomorrow, being able to actually do the work, help people get gender-affirming surgeries, have people have name changes, things that I struggled to do as a young trans woman growing up. So I just want to leave you all with this. In the world of darkness, be kind, because you never know who needs your kindness. And definitely be true, because you never know who hope lies in your truth. Thank you so much for this award. I'm going to hold my torch high, because it is work to do, and we got to do this work. Monica, like I said, you live through all of us. Thank you, guys. Have a blessed evening. Mwah.
Okay, so now we've come to the time for a little entertainment. So I want you all to give a thunderous round of applause for the iconic, fabulous, multi-talented Miss Tasha Long.
So many places in my life and time. I've sung a lot of songs and made some bad rhymes. I did all my life on stages with 10,000 people watching. Well, but we're alone now, and I'm singing a song to you. I love you in a place, my dear friend, where there's no space or time. I love you for my life. You are a friend of mine. And when my life is over, remember when we were together. You are alone.
People need someone to look up to,
I've never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. Yeah, it's a lonely place to be, so I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to want anyone's shadows. If I fail, if I succeed, at least don't live inside. I believe no matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all is happening to me. Inside of me. Dreaming of should leave you two alone. Let place just fall. Find your strength.
Get another thunderous round of applause for Miss Tasha Long. That's what you call entertainment. A lot of people get on stage and they perform, but she just got on stage and she entertained. There's a difference. Next, we're going to introduce, all the way from Atlanta, Georgia, the beautiful Miss Justine Ingram.
Hey, everybody. I'm Justine Ingram. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I'm representing Trans Housing Atlanta program, as well as the Vision for Hope Incorporated. So I'm actually sitting in the car because we just had our I Am Human and Trans Visibility March billboard unveiling, which went really, really good. So we're super glad that we're granted the opportunity here in Atlanta. And I'm very, very happy that I'm able to present the next two awards to the next two ladies. So the first award goes to Tori Cooper. So Tori Cooper is a health and equity consultant, a CDC subject matter expert,
NTVC subject matter expert, educator, author, and leader in the transgender and HIV communities. Recently honored as one of the most influential LGBTQ Georgians. She brings 30 years of experience in HIV service and is founder of Advocates for Better Care Atlanta. Tori serves as director of community engagement at the Human Rights Campaign, with a focus on economic empowerment, capacity building programs, public safety, and strategic communications. Ms. Cooper was recently appointed as the first Black trans woman appointed to the Presidential Advisory Council on HIV and AIDS, PACA, for the Biden administration. Give Tori Cooper another round of applause.
Okay, so our next award recipient is Courtney Harvey. So Courtney Harvey is a native of New Orleans, Louisiana, and she moved to Mississippi at the age of 10. Courtney is a graduate of Jackson State University, where she majored in sociology. Courtney is an advocate and activist for the trans community in Atlanta, Georgia. She is the creator and founding of the March for the Girls, which happened in March 28, 2017. Courtney is the founder of Light Incorporated and national conferences and other convenings. So we want to congratulate Courtney Harvey and welcome her.
Hi, everyone. I would like to give a shout out to A Vision for Hope, where I work. And I also like to give shouts out to everyone in Atlanta, Georgia, where I reside. Thank you. And then I'd like to accept this award on behalf of the Trans March.
Harvey, another round of applause, please. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have another entertainer, and she goes by the professional name of Miss Dominique Morgan.
Marching on, no matter if I felt like I was strong, the road was filled with traps and trials. I hadn't seen faith for miles, and down the road I see some hope. My journey has a purpose, this I know. Now I see the reasons why that some nights I had to cry, that some losses had to be. They all made a stronger me, and I stand before you now. I can't explain exactly how I am everything and more and more. I am my dream, I am my parents' everlasting wish. I am my dream, I am the product of my loved one's silent prayers. I am my dream, standing tall, glowing, shining, I won't fall. I am my dream, come to life today. I proclaim, I am my dream. December 23rd, 09, my mother left my side and I couldn't comprehend the why. I said a prayer to God to let me die. 11 years have passed since then. The hurt I had, I turned to win. Underneath my golden wings, I'm flying higher than I dare to dream. Now I see the reasons why, that some nights I had to cry, that some losses had to be. They all made a stronger me, and I stand before you now. Can't explain exactly how I am everything and more and more.
I am my dream,
my dream,
my
yeah, yeah, yeah,
everlasting wish.
I am my dream, I am the product of their praise, of their praise,
standing tall, shining, I won't fall. I am my dream, come to life. I proclaim, I am my dream.
Now I know the reasons why, that some nights I had to cry, and some losses need to be. They all made stronger me, and I stand before you now. Can't explain exactly how I am better than before.
I am my dream.
I'm more than everlasting wish.
I am my dream.
I am the product of their prayer, of their prayer, standing tall.
I am my
dream. I am my dream. I am right here. I proclaim I am my dream.
The very beautiful Miss Dominique Morgan. Give another round of applause. I see a few trendsetters and a few people out in the audience tonight who are doing some amazing things. Give a thunderous round of applause to Mr. Angus Bradshaw. He's doing a lot. He's doing a lot. The new director for Equality Florida, Ms. Nicole Parker. And my next introduction is for Mr. Josh Bell. Thunderous round of applause.
Oh, thank you. I love you too. Yeah. Well, thank you for the opportunity to present a couple of these awards. Greetings from the city of Orlando, from One Orlando Alliance. I know people are watching this all over the country and even probably around the world. And I want to tell you that there are amazing people in each of the locations where people are watching. And I have a special place in my heart for the amazing people I see in this room from Orlando. So thank you for the opportunity to honor them. And thank you for the opportunity to present these awards. The first award that I get to present is to Robin Daly. Big round of applause for Robin. Robin is part of Zebra Coalition, which is an organization here in Orlando that does amazing work with youth 13 to 24 years old. Robin joined Zebra Coalition in 2017 as the community engagement manager. And in this role, Robin was responsible for executing community outreach initiatives, connecting to the community, and raising awareness for Zebra Coalition. And they did that spectacularly. I met Robin first and foremost out in the community, tabling, telling people about their amazing work. Recently, Robin's transitioned into a new role as the housing program manager, where they oversee Zebra Coalition's short-term housing programs for youth 18 to 24 years old, an incredibly important work. Robin holds certifications in nonprofit management, volunteer management, proposal and grant writing, and leadership practices from Rollins College, the Edith Bush Institute. Robin is also certified in youth mental health first aid as an instructor through the National Council for Behavioral Health. And Robin is a newlywed, and their spouse, Melanie, is here tonight. Y'all, we love Robin so much. We are so proud of them, and we are honored to present this award to you tonight.
Thank you, everyone. I'm a little nervous, so give me some grace. So first, I want to thank the National Trans Visibility March Award Committee for selecting me as one of this year's honorees. I'm humbled to receive an award in the name of such a trailblazing, award-winning activist for trans non-binary people, Monica Roberts. Rest in power. I'm so touched by this. I also want to acknowledge the amazing trans and non-binary leaders here locally that have paved the way for me to even be here today. Some of the people are in the room that I respect and love so much. There are many visible and vocal leaders here in Orlando. I just want to lift those people up because they've been such an amazing example to all of us here in the community. You know, and the reason we're here tonight, visibility is the key word, right? On the eve of the National Trans Visibility March, I'm really proud to be part of the host team here in Orlando, having this event here. This march changed my life in 2019. I was part of the crew that bused to D.C. from Orlando and marched, and traveling to D.C., standing with those folks, walking with not only people from my community but from people all around the country was one of the most powerful experiences I've ever had. And although many of the community leaders here in Orlando have played a big role in being visible to me during my journey, it's really the youth and young adults that I work with who have really just touched my heart and who inspire me every day. The young people that we see at Zebra Coalition coming through the door every day on a daily basis are some of the most courageous folks that I've ever met. The challenges that they face on a daily basis, from family rejection to bullying in school, physical and mental abuse at home, you know, they really stand tall in their authenticity, and they seek to find their truth, knowing the cost may be very high. I accept this award tonight, honoring all those youth and young adults who have inspired me and those of us in the room and around the country, and the trans and non-binary people who inspire us every day. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Robin, and the work that you are doing, just showing up as yourself and inspiring the youth of Zebra Coalition in our community. We love you and we're grateful for you. The next award that I get to present to a member of the Orlando community goes to Ms. Aja Gamble. Big round of applause for Aja Gamble. Yes. Aja was born in Fort Pierce off the Treasure Coast in sunny South Florida, and she graduated from high school in 87. She continued her studies at the local state college, got her AA, and attended University of Florida in the College of Education. In 1991, she moved to the beautiful city of Orlando, where she was learning more about who she was, and she was being affected mentally and emotionally. At this time, the trans community was an underground world where one would only be seen during the late nights soliciting services. There was nowhere to go for help and to feel safe. So before there was any funding, she opened up her home for transient girls and girls who were recently released from jails and prisons. She offered a safe haven and meals and shelter and clothing. Healthcare was minimal because of the stigma that was affecting trans women at that time. And then in 1998, the late, great Mr. Lowell Stafford offered her a job, being the first agency in Central Florida ever to hire a trans person of color to assist her in her endeavors to support the trans community. And throughout these years, she has continued to be an advocate and an activist for all the LGBTQ plus community. And currently, she is the chief board member for Divas in Dialogue, a support group for trans women under Miracle of Love. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Aja Gamble.
Representing Unspoken Treasure Society, directed by the lovely Miss Regina Livingston. And Mulan, could you stand up for us, please? She is the director of Divas and Dialogue, and that's where I am currently at right now. Was I expecting this today? No. Do I deserve it? Of course, yes. Yes, yes. But I want to accept this award tonight for all the ones that are not here with us. It's like bittersweet because they didn't have the chance. And even the ones, like when I was watching the memoriam earlier this week, and oh, that was just too many girls just gone. And Marissa? Okay. Yeah, she mentioned something about safety. What does safety look like? That stuck with me. And it bothered me, and because a lot of people didn't understand what you were talking about, but I understood. Safety can mean a lot of things. And I want all of the agencies to try to incorporate that into their videos or whatever you do, your podcast. Make them understand, because I thought that was a nice thing. But all in all, I'm very humbled and very grateful and thankful for receiving this. Thank you.
Y'all, I need this room to get a little louder. This is the National Torture Awards. This is a room full of the most marginalized community in America. So I think you should give more of a thunderous round of applause for these fabulous people that are doing these amazing things. I need some noise in this room. Thank you. Thank you. And every time we call an awardee out, please give the same thunderous applause, okay? Because if they're not going to do it for us, we have to do it for each other. That's what community is about. Next, I want to introduce Mr. Javon Martin.
All right, good evening, everyone.
Wait. Come on, y'all. Like she said, this is the National Trans Visibility March. Good evening, everyone. There we go. Give it up for yourself for being here. All right, we are visible. Come on, y'all. This is important. This is about us, celebrating us. Come on, y'all. So I'm here today to present the Monica Roberts Award to Diamond Collier. Diamond Styles has been a long... Currently, she is the host and producer of Marsha's Plate, a weekly podcast that archives and centers the trans social justice movement and pro-black feminist culture. She is the executive director of Black Trans Women, Inc., a national nonprofit that is focused on social advocacy, economic equity, and building strong leadership among Black trans women. I give you Diamond Style.
Hey, brother, how are you? Oh my God, I am so filled with gratitude and humility just to be receiving a damn award in the spirit of Monica. Oh my God. I mean, that's just amazing because she was a personal friend. She was a mentor. She was somebody that inspired me. That just makes me feel good. But on top of that, to be receiving it from my own damn community, that's what's affirming. I don't care about no Oscar, no white people stuff, no cisgender people stuff. I care about my community, and to receive an award for them from them means so much to me. Your legacy is about who you actually touch in life. And I am so glad to be in a space where I came out in the 90s. None of this visibility, none of this community building was happening on this level. But there were people who inspired me. Girls on the block who taught me how to get money and taught me how to survive. Butch queens who supported me when motherfuckers were trying to bully me. Drag queens who inspired me to be the best chick I am. You know, so many people touched my life then, and I love that. I'm so glad and grateful that I am alive to see the work that all those old school girls paved the way for us to be here right now. And I'm so glad that I'm here adding my drop to the bucket. I so appreciate this. Thank you so much. I love y'all. Even some of you hoes that I don't really like that much, I still love you and want you to prosper. But thank you so much. I appreciate you. And thank you. Monica, rest in peace.
Thank you, Diamond. Thank you very much. Well deserved, my sister. Yeah. Thank you. Yes, from around the way. And the next recipient is Kim Watson. This lady is near and dear to my heart, and I'm gonna stick to the script. But I could talk about Kim from the heart. I'm gonna stick to the script. Kim, yes, yeah, I got you. Kim Watson is the co-founder of Community Kinship Life, known as CK Life, that assists affirmed men and women with necessity life skills, medical needs, counseling, and access to the resources needed to improve their quality of life and contribution to society. CK Life provides a safe, secure space for affirmed people and allies when applicable. Learn about, come on now, work with me, to meet and learn about life inside and outside of transition. CK Life also sponsors a benefit to raise funds for the CK Life Scholarship Fund that has helped many affirmed people with paying for necessity transition-related procedures. CK Life also participates in many conferences centered around affirmed people, such as the WPATH, the Philly Trans Health Conference in Philadelphia, and many more. People across the United States have benefited from the selfless acts of Kim Watson and the CK Life organization. CK Life has set a precedence for nonprofit organizations that assist affirmed people and continues to do amazing things in the community at large. Kim is also the author of her first book called The Modern Day Woman. And I give you my auntie, Kim Watson.
My auntie, Kim Watson.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
You know, receiving. Thank you, Devon. Getting such a prestigious award, the Monica Roberts Award. I follow the instructions as usual, and oh my goodness. Yeah, I follow the instructions because, you know, when Marissa said to do something, you do it. You follow Marissa's instructions. You do not ever go against what Marissa Miller said. So she said, don't open it. And this is the first time I'm seeing it. I want to say thank you. Thank you. I want to say thank you to all those new activists. I want to say thank you to all those individuals who I stand on their shoulders. I want to say thank you for all those individuals who have questions and stuff like that. And being one of the first individuals to have a transgender clinic and medical facility, I want to tell you, I'm just one of the first. There's a lot of other firsts. And one of the things I've learned to do, and what Monica has learned to do, although she was showing up and showing out and very loud, I have the same thing. But I've learned to step up and step back. And I want you to know that at some time, this community can burn you out. This community can burn you out. However, you take some self-care, you rest, you breathe, and you come on back. And that's what I've done. I want to say thank you to each and every one of you. And I want to go with what Diamond said. Whether you like me or I like you, I want to say thank you to you for choosing me for such a precious award. You understand? Monica was my sister. We started the first trans conference back in Louisiana, Kentucky. And I know they said keep it to 2 minutes to 3 minutes. However, if you want to give me a call, you know, y'all could give me a call. And I wish I was in Orlando, because I would make sure that Orlando wouldn't owe me anything. I want to say thank you, Marissa. I want to say thank you to you and your team. I want to say thank you to all of the volunteers. I want to say thank you to all the trans masculine men out there that made sure that this happened. I want to thank the trans women, the non-binary, and the gender non-conforming individuals. I love you, and I hope that this continues pushing forward. Marissa, thank you, my sister. I love you.
That's my auntie, y'all. She's long-winded. All right, and the next recipient for the Monica Roberts Award goes to Tatiana Williams. All right. Yes. Tatiana Williams is the co-founder and executive director of Trans Inclusive Group. She has been an advocate for the LGBT community for 20 plus years. Ms. Williams is an active participant in the community at many different levels. She has established, maintained, and developed positive relationships with community stakeholders and elected officials who promote legislation that supports the TGNC community. Tatiana is also a council member of Equality Florida, Human Rights National Board of Governors, and chair for the Broward County.
When we think about the lives that we have lost when it comes to our black and brown siblings, we have to stay vigilant in this fight. It's important to me, and I thank you to the sponsors. I thank you to One Alliance, and I thank you, Marissa, for making sure that you came and held this march here in Florida. That is important to me as well, because so often Florida is left behind. And I got to say, the Florida girls are stepping up. We're not taking that. We're not taking that. We are making sure that our people are seen. We are making sure that we are counted, and we are out here doing the work. I can recall when we talked about Divas of the Dialogue and Unspoken Treasure, when I was doing the work, when I had a little group, because this is what I tell people. I had the passion, right? The passion to do the work. But what I so understood in the assignment, it had to have a business model. And it's important to put that behind it. And what I see in what I put and showed for these young ladies, it is coming to fruition. And that's how we mobilize. That's how we move the community. That's how we build on the community. And I thank you, Monica Roberts, for setting that pace for us, because we needed that. All of these leaders that came before us and before me, we needed that. I thank you, Angus. I thank you for giving Mulan the opportunity to grow. I thank you. I appreciate that, and I'm humbly grateful that you was able to do that. Thank you, Regina. Thank you for doing your work. Thank you, Marissa, as well. And I thank everybody that's watching this. It's important that we advocate. It's important that we stay active, and most importantly, we must be vigilant when doing this work to make sure that our voices are heard and make sure that they see us. Oftentimes, they created this system to oppress us, but we won't be oppressed, and we will be seen, and we are here, and we will be here. And thank you this evening. It was an honor, and thank you.
Give Tatiana Williams another thunderous round of applause. I can't hear you. Give her a thunderous round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, let me just say something to y'all. We complain often about them not seeing us. We have to see us first in order for them to see us. So when we come up here tonight, I wanted every person, don't slack, everyone that takes this podium tonight deserves a thunderous round of applause. Don't slack. Okay, and our next announcee is Dr. Darren Johnson.
How y'all doing? Hope y'all having a good time. I'm Dr. Darren Johnson, Director of Programs at Us Helping Us, People Into Living Incorporated, a nonprofit HIV services organization in Washington, D.C. I have the honor and privilege to present two Monica Roberts Awards. Our first recipient, Eliza Claiborne Crosby, is a Sacramento-based social justice leader and has spent the last two decades advocating for trans women of color. She is the founder of Melanin Movement, a fully functioning program for trans women of color. Ms. Claiborne Crosby is also the founder of Trans Family Day, a celebration for trans and non-binary people and their families. Congratulations, Eliza Claiborne Crosby.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. It is such a pleasure to be here with you all today. This award, it has me speechless because I'm a fan of Monica Roberts. She was such an inspiration to me in my fight for justice for all of my sisters. Thank you very much. I'm really speechless. I don't know how to thank you all more. Marissa, oh my God, I'm like such a fan of yours. And I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you all. Good night.
Specialist for an expanded learning program. Demi is a community organizer infamous for her blacktop bougie events. Ms. Gooch, is also the board secretary for Black Women United, which is an organization that strives to educate, protect, and aid in the advancement of all Black women. Ms. Gooch says, trans people are natural leaders that often get overlooked when opportunities arise. Even if it means creating our own, we must. Congratulations, Demi Gooch.
Hello. This is extremely exciting. I am so humbled and so honored to be receiving this award. It's not often that you hear about the trans community here in Sacramento, and I feel just so blessed to be a representative of the work that is done out here day in and day out. I'm in the company of very many greats, so thank you all for the love and recognition. As an educator, I am constantly pushing my students to identify and address problems in their communities. And I help strategize with them to address those issues. And it just wasn't right for me to be sitting on the wayside, not addressing the things that were happening here in Sacramento here with my trans brothers and sisters. So that's what initially got me into the work. Thank you. Not much of a speaker. So I just want to express my appreciation. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, all my support crew. You guys are amazing, and I definitely could not do this without you. Have a good evening.
Our next step is we're going to do a memoriam for those that are not here. So if you would all turn towards the projectors. Thank you.
fame.
The next person I'll be introducing you to is Miss Michaela Cross.
Hello, everyone. My name is Michaela Cross. I work for BU Wellness Network. I am their outreach facilitator. BU Wellness Network is an all-black nonprofit organization that has been servicing Indianapolis for 20 years now. So tonight, I will be introducing the Community Ally Awards. The first recipient is going to be Joyce Almedia. Joyce is a cisgender ally and honored of served previously on the board to Come Out with Pride Orlando and currently on the executive board of Unspoken Treasure Society. She works diligently to create and lift up events, celebrations, and installations serving transgender individuals one-on-one and the transgender community. Whether a transgender support circle meeting twice a month since 2017, organizing a bus trip from Orlando to the Visibility March in Washington, or hosting an annual transgender pool party since 2018, you can count on this Pride Chamber 2018 Volunteer of the Year to be there to serve. Miss Joyce Amelia.
Thank you. It is a great joy in my life. Sorry, I'm a crier. It's like some people are huggers, I'm a crier, it's annoying. It is a great joy of my life to be welcomed into this community and to serve this community. And the Trans Visibility March meant so much to so many, changed so many lives. Thank you so much for the hard work you do, and thank you for this. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Joyce. Give her another round of applause, please. Our next recipient is Dr. Allison Matthew Streamyard. Dr. Allison Matthews serves as Executive Director of Gilead Compass Faith Coordinating Center and Research Fellow in Faith and Health in the School of Divinity at Work, Wake Forest University. She specializes in integrating technology, social marketing, community engagement, and social science to examine the intersections of race, class, gender, sexuality, and religiosity on HIV-related stigma. Thank you. And to innovate clinical research engagement and access to healthcare for underserved populations. Dr. Matthews has been invited to speak about HIV, COVID-19, and national international platforms, including about HIV and HIV COVID, text that carry women. Dr. Matthews and Mrs. Kimberly Knight co-founded and had December 14th officially declared by the state of North Carolina as an HIV Cure Research Day to raise awareness about HIV cure research and encourage community involvement in ending the HIV epidemic. She earned her BA in sociology from Howard University and her MA and PhD in sociology from UNC Chapel Hill. She completed her doctoral work at UNC Chapel Hill in the Department of Social Medicine and the Institute for Global Health and Infectious Disease. Please welcome, let's welcome Ms. Dr. Allison Matthews.
All right. Thank you so much. This award just means so much to me. I was very surprised, but also very honored to receive this award and to be named a community ally. As you know, as an ally, as a co-conspirator, I'd like to, you know, also just thank Carmarian Anderson Harvey and Marissa Miller, Sunny Bad, and many of the people living with HIV who I've known and grown to love over these years, including Angela Vick, Ladarius Turner, Michael Wilson, Arthur Jackson. And also just kind of let you all know that the Gilead Compass Coordinating Center, or the Faith Coordinating Center, is here to advocate and to educate people about the divinity that is within all of us, including trans women and men, and to advocate for love and acceptance and to work with faith leaders to move the needle forward so that we no longer have to experience faith-based trauma. So thank you for this award, and I'm so happy to accept it and be in company with you all.
Thank you so much. Our next recipient is Kirk Myers. Come on. Kirk D. Myers, Kirk D. Myers, MPH, is a Dallas native with a deep passion for serving the needs of Black LGBTQ plus community. He is the founder and CEO of Abounding Prosperity, Inc., and leading social service agency, a member of the Dallas LGBT Task Force, serves as PrEP advisory board member for the Gilead Sciences, Inc. AIDS Vaccine Advocacy Coalition Program, and the visionary behind Dallas Southern Pride, the largest Black gay pride and Juneteenth celebration in Texas. His pride events have attracted tens of thousands of attendees and pumped millions into regional economy. Kirk Myers cannot be here tonight, but we still want to give him the praise and receiving this award tonight.
Bear with us, we only have a few left. Our next performance is going to come from Miss Paris Hockett.
Hello, everyone. I'm Paris Hockett from DC, pronouns they, them, theirs. Everywhere, everywhere, everywhere I go, everywhere that I've been, the only thing I see is beautiful people, beautiful people, beautiful people, beautiful people. Your beauty deep inside, inside you. Don't let them bring you down, no. The beauty is inside you. Don't let them bring you down, no. Don't you know, don't you know. Beautiful, don't you know. Don't you know, don't you know. No, 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 no. it's your life. Your beauty's deep inside you. Don't let them bring you down, no. The beauty is inside you. Don't let them bring you down, no. Oh, oh.
That message was amazing, don't you know? Our next speaker would be the beautiful and the amazing Miss Nicole Parker.
Good evening, everybody. How's everyone doing today? Good. I have the amazing honor of presenting the Marsha P. Johnson Lifetime Pioneer Award to the amazing, my former boss, Gina Duncan. Gina Duncan stepped away from senior management position in a 30-year position in mortgage banking to advocate for the LGBTQ community. Gina was a member of the Orlando HRC field team and was elected 2 terms as president of the LGBTQ Chamber of Commerce in Central Florida and ran for Orange County Commissioner before joining Equality Florida as their statewide director of equality. Since that time, Gina has been national and international educator and an advocate for the transgender community, facilitating over 400 workshops and working with over 1,000 corporations, healthcare organizations, law enforcement agencies, colleges, universities, and related nonprofits. Gina is a recognized spokesperson for transgender rights and for the passage of gender-affirming public policy at the local, state, and national level. Let's give an amazing round of applause for Gina Duncan.
Good evening to my extended family in Orlando, and thank you so much, Nicole. This recognition is so special and made even more so by being introduced by my amazing colleague and my dear friend, Nicole Parker. Nicole Parker is going to do some amazing things for our community, so stand by. I also want to thank my family members, David and Lisa Pinkston in Rockledge, Florida, who are watching tonight and are so supportive of our community. You know, after receiving a Lifetime Pioneer Award named after a community icon, Marsha P. Johnson, it can't get much better than this. This is so beautiful, and I am so honored. Thank you so much to the National Trans Visibility March, Nation Z, and One Orlando Alliance for this humbling recognition. This is such a special time in Orlando, and a benchmark moment for trans and non-binary visibility. And as you know, our visibility is so important. Visibility leads to awareness. Awareness leads to education. And through that education, people gain more knowledge about the trans and non-binary communities, and that leads to social equity. In a time when anti-trans legislation and trans Violence is on the uprise. It is so important that we commit to the adage of no lives left behind. In a time when we're being attacked in all aspects of our lives, trans youth healthcare bans, trans sports bans, rising transgender murders nationwide, disproportionate unemployment and homelessness due to COVID. No lives left behind must be our commitment to each other in this space. Our strength is our diversity. Our power is our inclusion. Ensuring that everyone has a seat at the table and everyone has a voice in our movement is so important. Only together can we fight the hate. Only together can our community continue to step out of the shadows and into the light of equality. Together, through our visibility, we can move the moral compass of our nation to a safer, more inclusive, and more compassionate place. For all of our community, all transgender, non-conforming, and non-binary Americans, I hope everyone has an amazing march tomorrow. I hope you have a great Come Out with Pride. And I want to once again thank you for this wonderful honor. Onward.
Next, I want to introduce Sharon Grayson, founder, CEO, nonprofit, and commuter. And Consumer Services Network, Little Rock, Arkansas, and an innovative and strategic program developer, nonprofit administrative management specialist and consultant, speaker, and professional grant writer of over 35 years. Sharon holds a bachelor's degree in business from Texas State University. Let's give a big round of applause for Sharon Grayson.
Hello, everybody in Orlando. I am so, so honored to be the recipient of this award. It means so much because it's named after a dear friend and someone I admire. Working with my community over the years has been a tremendously rewarding experience. There's a lot more that we have to do. And as Gina said, we can do this working together. It's going to be important that we work together. I'm going to be brief in my thank yous and sincerest appreciation for this esteemed honor. Thank you, Orlando community. Thank you. To the NTVM community and team, I'm just so honored. And I am going to take very good care of this extraordinary piece here. Thank you. Thank you all.
Give her another round of applause, please. Our next speaker would be Miss Sabrina Kent. Go to the projectors.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sabrina Kent. I use she, her pronouns, and I'm the Senior Vice President overseeing supplier diversity and programs at the National LGBT Chamber of Commerce. And it's such a pleasure to be here with you all virtually for the Torch Awards for the third year in a row now. I'm so honored to present the overall Torch Award tonight to an incredible advocate. Gilead Sciences has been committed to creating a healthier world for everyone, no matter the challenges ahead. For more than 30 years, Gilead pursued the impossible, chased it down, tackled it for answers, and surrounded it for a way in. Gilead has worked tirelessly to bring forward medicines for life-threatening diseases. Through bold and transformative science, Gilead is driving innovation that has the potential to become the next generation of life-changing medicines. Hispanic Executive noted in their February 2021 feature on Diana Feliz Oliva, as the Associate Director of Public Affairs, Patient Advocacy, and Community Engagement at Gilead, she's found the first role in her life where she's able to truly be herself. Oliva has fought for every victory, personal and professional. At Gilead Sciences, she calls on a lifetime of LGBTQ plus outreach and experience to ease the way for others. Congratulations, Diana.
Good evening. My name is Diana Feliz Oliva, and I'm the Associate Director of Advocacy and Community Engagement at Gilead Sciences. On behalf of our leadership team and thousands of employees from across the globe, I am proud to accept this award on behalf of Gilead Sciences and to receive the special recognition at the National Transgender Visibility March for our continuing work to support transgender communities across the country. At Gilead Sciences, we know it takes more than medicine to address the disproportionate impact of HIV within the transgender community. We know the path forward is not easy. But when I see firsthand of the work of the National Transgender Visibility March, innovating during the COVID-19 pandemic, I know that our transgender communities are ready for any challenges. Once again, thank you for this special award and recognition at the National Transgender Visibility March, and have a wonderful evening.
Tomorrow, history will be made in Florida. We will have our first National Trans Visibility March here in Florida. Y'all know y'all got to get louder than that. Okay, because this is Florida. History is being made and we're happy. There's going to be a map on screen of the rally. One p.m. rally slideshows and speakers. And 2 p.m. the march will begin. I'm inviting each of you and all our allies to come along with you to witness a historical moment, the third National Trans Visibility March here in Florida, Orlando, Florida. That's a beautiful thing. Our next award is going to go to Minister Lois L. Bates. Yes. Yes. One moment. I got a little ahead of myself. We're gonna go to one more performance from the iconic, the beautiful Miss Everything, Tasha Long.
Thank you.
We're honoring the late Minister Lois L. Bates. Bates was transgender health manager at Howard Brown Health Center and was an active advocate for the HIV community. She was an active member of Lakeview Action Coalition and was a co-founder of the Chicago Transgender Coalition. Her past work included serving in program directory of the Minority Outreach Intervention Project and as vice president of Chicago Windy City Black Pride. She also served on the HIV Prevention Planning Group, as well as the Chicago Area Ryan White Services Planning Council. So she was amazing. And I'm sure she left an amazing legacy. The recipient for this award is Miss Beautiful Fendi Divine. Fendi Divine is a community health worker, educator, activist, advocate, and speaker. She has worked in the field since 2013, starting as a volunteer for different organizations in the community. During her volunteer work, she grew a large passion for reaching her community and to provide support, strength, and encouragement to those she encountered. She grew up with the values of community and strong ties to giving back and nurturing those in need. Prior to working in the field of HIV and the human rights movement, she shared a passion for organization, management and training, and customer service development in retail and hospitality environments. Let us behold Miss Beautiful Fendi Divine.
Good evening, good evening, and salutations to everyone of the sound of my voice. It is indeed a great honor and pleasure, and I'm very humbled to receive this award tonight. I just thank you all from the bottom of my heart. I will cherish this award for the rest of my life. Now for the unveiling. Thank you so much, National Trans Visibility March, and everyone that had everything to do with this great movement. Once again, I thank you. God bless.
The next recipient of the Minister Lois L. Bates Award is Ms. Naomi Green. Clap, clap, clap. Naomi Green is a 38-year-old African-American woman of trans experience. Her advocacy began in 2004 with her partnership with agencies and colleagues that performed outreach prioritizing trans women and YMSM in the house ballroom community while attending Jackson State University. She then went on to complete her MBA at the University of Missouri. She was courted by Abounding Prosperity, Inc. to become their transgender Simply One. To become their transgender programs manager in Dallas. While her work bridges over into many mediums, her mission is Simply One: to provide insight about what is needed to improve the lives of transgender women and their families. Her overachieving tool is not only her insight into this community, but her lens as she sees it as a trans woman who understands the plight of all trans women, regardless of race, serial status, socioeconomic status, and any other marker in which they exist. give a round of applause for Miss Naomi Green.
Hi. Thank you so much for this award. It's definitely humbling and an honor to, first of all, be nominated, but definitely to receive this award. It's truly a blessing and a testament to God that I'm even here today to be able to be in front of you and accept this award. Being a victim of gun violence and a shooting that happened in my car with a friend of mine, and him losing his life and me surviving that situation is really what made me start to evaluate what I was doing and really discovering a new purpose and wanting to be able to support and advocate for my trans sisters and brothers. So I always say that it was God who brought me into this work, who brought me to Dallas, that allowed my best friend to meet and introduced me to my current CEO, my first mentor, Mr. Kirk Myers, who really shared his vision with me of what it was going to take for me to be successful in doing this work. So I definitely would not be here without him taking a chance on me and giving me my first opportunity to be an advocate. And there are plenty of mentors that I have met along the way, some of which are excellent women that have been awarded tonight. First being Ms. Carmarian Anderson Harvey, Mrs., excuse me, who really paved the way and showed me what it looked like to be a Black trans woman as an advocate in Dallas, Texas, and doing the work. So I'm forever thankful, along with a few other women like Dr. Jasmine Ward, Ms. Tori Cooper, and several others that I could name. So thank all of you who have contributed to my journey and allowed me to be here. Last but definitely not least, I have to thank my biggest ally in my entire life, which is my mother. Thank you, Latanza Green, for loving me, for building me up so that others would not be able to tear me down. I'm forever indebted. I love you. I thank you for always being there and for always being the one to open doors for me and show others what it means to be accepting and loving of a trans woman. Thank you to the community of Dallas for opening your arms to me and allowing me to become the leader and advocate that I am in your community. I'm humbled, I'm honored. Thank all of you and the work that you all do. Thank you. I'm gonna go ahead and open my award. Wow. This is amazing.
Can we get a thunderous round of applause? When I asked for a thunderous round of applause, I want it to be thunderous. Give us a thunderous round of applause. Thank you. Along with us tomorrow, we won't be the only city in America marching. We will also be marching in Atlanta, Georgia. We will be marching in Sacramento, California. And we will be marching in New York. Y'all a mess with y'all thunderous rounds of applause. I'm gonna have to get with y'all. And if anybody knows me, you don't want me to get with y'all. I like to, when I ask for a thunderous, so we've gotten our awards out. I want to take a moment to invite you all again out tomorrow for the third annual National Transgender Visibility March here in Orlando, Florida. Give us a round of applause. See you tomorrow.